How's it going, YouTube, and welcome back to First Timers. Now today on the Baby Edition, we're going to be doing something a little different. We're going to be going over five products that have helped me and my wife out during the last 3.5 months. And I'll kind of go over each product so you can kind of judge how we use them and how they can actually maybe affect your life and maybe help out, you know, especially if you're a brand new parent. You know, like I said, we're only 3.5 months in and there's been a lot of challenges and changes. And, you know, obviously one of the biggest things that we don't have enough of is time. So I kind of also want to show you a couple products in there as well that will actually help you save time as well. But anyway, to keep everything short, like I said, we're going to do everything on the computer and I'll actually tell you what I love about each product and how we use it and all that fun stuff. So let's jump into it. The first one is actually going to be this guy here. It's actually soft, stretchy. It's meant to cover car seats like one we got right here. Now the idea is to actually, you know, usually keep the sun and, you know, sun off the baby in the car seat while you're carrying them around so they're not going blind at the sun. But what we've been using them for is when we go to like the hospital and stuff like that. Obviously they don't make masks small enough for little babies and all that fun stuff. So this guy actually fits right over the stroller. Obviously it's on the car seat with the stroller. You can literally fit it right over, close up the baby in there as we're walking through, because where we go at Kaiser, they kind of funnel you through and everybody kind of goes through the same entrance. And so that's always worried me because obviously, hey, I don't want my son to get sick and all that fun stuff. So I've really been trying to, I've been trying to work something out where I it makes me feel better that I can actually cover my son without having to, you know, expose him to, you know, any, you know, not even just like coronavirus, but, you know, really expose him to any outside elements, you know, like might be able to get them sick, might get them sunburned, all that fun stuff. So it definitely has been a big help. But if we move over to the computer here, you're also going to notice people actually use this on carts as well. And I would have never thought about that, but you could flip it around, kind of go around the cart. Now anywhere the kid touches, they're touching the actual cover itself, and now you don't have to worry about that. But again, like I said, it was originally designed for car seats and to keep the sun off the, you know, sun off your child and all that fun stuff. And again, it's very stretchy, very soft. I will definitely put a description, a link below, so you guys can go and take a look at a few. Definitely really, really, really cool item to actually have. Now, the next item is actually something that we already kind of did like an unboxing and kind of set up on the stroller. And again, that is part of the stroller. It's going to be what we call the Mom Cozy. I don't want to pull it off just because my little one is sleeping, but I do want to kind of showcase it here just so you guys can take a look at it here. But overall, you do have little zipper pockets. Everything is kind of has like this little cooling material. So you can kind of slot, you know, drop in your actual baby bottles or even your own personal drink. Even though the stroller does have a little cup holder on the side, I've been typically using these more often. But, you know, some of the days have been, you know, 80s, you know, high 80s, 90s, walking, you know, we're walking them at 8 o'clock at night and it's still 80 degrees outside. So being able to have something that actually stays pretty cool and being able to actually feed the baby on the, you know, on our walk out has actually been amazing. I'll kind of show you a quick picture of like both the actual, you know, the actual cover and the Mom Cozy. Obviously it doesn't look like I'm using it heavily in the picture, but I just, you know, like I said, I do put my phone, you know, I put my phone and my wife's phone inside the center pocket here, just so I could drop it in. We do carry a diaper and one other thing in there. We don't go fully crazy, but when we want to, you know, take a little Alvin out further, I should say, I could see that, you know, becoming a big, big help. But right now, since we're really not taking them to stores and all that fun stuff, what we're carrying is actually very simple and very good to use right now. Now, if you do go over to their website, momcozy.com, they do have a interesting selection of bags here that you can definitely, you know, you can definitely get some that look like little side tote bags, to backpacks, to even stroller bags that are even bigger than this particular guy. Now, like I said, just depending on how crazy you want to go, you can definitely go to the bigger ones. Like this one, they're kind of showing like a little picnic bag there. Where the one I have is, it could be used as a side bag and on the strollers, but it looks like they have two-tiered full-on baby stroller bags, and those almost kind of look like fun Disney Day stroller type of bags, which I think is pretty cool, and hopefully we can actually take my son to Disneyland at some point. We would be very excited to do that, and obviously we can definitely test this bag out and probably carry a side bag which can drop underneath. But I could see how some of those bigger bags definitely can have a little more help in that sense. All right, so another great product is actually this guy here. It's made by Philips, and it's actually a microwave sterilizer. So it'll actually sterilize up to 4 bottles. Literally has a little tray inside that you can actually hold on and pull out once it's done. You do have to put a little bit of water inside here. I did mark mine on the inside, so when I fill it up, I don't have to keep asking my wife how much do I need to put in here. It literally has, I used a little bit of a razor blade to make the line, and that was it. So it was actually very quick and easy. I'd have to say something like this actually saved us about 10 minutes worth of time. And I know some people are kind of like, 10 minutes, obviously you have to sit there and boil water if you're doing it the boiling the water way. So you're boiling the water, you're waiting for the water to boil, and then you're putting stuff into it, and you have to watch it boil so it doesn't get all over the place with the water boiling and all that fun stuff. And for me, we still boil every other day, but we use this just to kind of nuke them, and saves us time. And obviously with my wife back to work, time is kind of crucial, and if she says, hey, I need another bottle, I think I need a pump, it's one of those things that boom, we can sit there and hand her a bottle in less than 2 minutes if I don't have any ready. But typically we're pretty good about sitting there using this guy and then getting it into one of the little bottle dryers for her. So definitely a big help. If we jump over to the computer here, you can kind of see what it shows here. Obviously holds up to 4 bottles. Obviously that's the bottles themselves and the nipples and the little nipple holders that hold it to the top of the bottle. So it's actually very easy to do. Now on our sterilizer, it obviously asks it, what's it called? It tells you how much you're supposed to put into the, how much water you're supposed to put into this, into the bottom of the pail or the container here. What I did is I used a razor blade and kind of engraved a little mark so I can actually sit there and just fill it to that line so I don't have to ever remember how much water it needs. So I literally just pull some water from the fridge, my filtered fridge, and literally throw it right into the microwave and start steaming things. And like I said, it's amazing. It pretty much kills 99.9% of germs, and hands down one of the things that can actually save a lot of time for new parents. Like I said, time is huge for me, and you'll get to some points where you're just like, I just wish I had more time. And so if you can add these items up, and it's saving you time over the next 3 years, definitely something that's crucial for most people. Now, like I said, my wife obviously is going back to work, and that's kind of a big thing where I have to, I'm sitting there doing the dishes and cleaning bottles and trying to get things ready for her, and cleaning actually the breast pump equipment and all that fun stuff, and getting it ready for her, just because I'm at home right now. So definitely, like I said, is a big help. And I have a lot of stuff that's on my plate as well. So again, 15 minutes versus 2 to 3 minutes, definitely recommend the microwave steam sterilizer made by Philips. This will be in the link below, so definitely check it out, guys. Now the next thing is another organizer for the diaper changing table. Now I know you guys probably saw the video that we did on there, but this has actually been a big help for us, where we can kind of just load all the diapers in there and have everything in one place. Obviously you can always get like a bin and kind of maybe have it on top, but if your baby's anything like our child, being able to for them to reach and grab things was kind of, you know, one of those things that I would say would probably have been an annoyance, or kicking things. So where this particular bag goes is it goes like on the side of the actual changing table, just so you can actually have everything laid off to the side. You have your wipes on top. You literally just grab the wipes from there and you're wiping away. And obviously you saw that we did a Diaper Genie unboxing and setup, and boom, old diaper and wipes go right into the Diaper Genie. Very quick, very easy. And this has actually been a very big help, just because it was one of those things that you kind of start to go through everything and you're just like, wow, I need more of this. I need lotion here. I need, you know, and so everything's just in one spot, easy to get to. And like I said, the diaper changing table has kind of been that medium where we can kind of go sit down our child, and then we can kind of go and grab everything that's right there. And right now he's starting to do his rolling thing. So there's actually like a little seat on the diaper thing, so it can kind of a seat belt, so it can kind of lock him in, so he's not rolling all over the place. But definitely you want to keep an eye on your child in those. But it gives us a minute to kind of say, hey, everything's right over here. I could still keep an eye on my child while I can grab things and get it all ready to go, so I can get the diaper changed or whatever you're trying to grab that's in this organizer. Definitely something that I would tell people to look into. Now, as you see on my screen here, I'm at the Hiccupop website, and you can kind of see how they have it set up, where they put the diapers obviously in the center. It looks like they have sheets and clothes off to the sides with baby powder and maybe lotion and something else that's there. But like I said, very easy and nice to use. I overloaded mine the first time I set it up with a whole bunch of diapers, and literally the thing took a full box of newborn diapers, and I was actually really impressed. I was like, wow, I didn't think I was gonna fit all those diapers. But yeah, obviously when I see the whole thing, like the hat, you know, the bag that it comes inside, one of the little Costco diaper bags or diaper boxes, and it was one of those things that I was impressed that it took a lot of those diapers. I should say the half a box of diapers, the package that it comes in wrapped in. But yeah, it was actually a very good product. Definitely would recommend as you're starting to go through everything and look at all these stuff, you know, look at everything here. It's very easy to set up, nothing too difficult. The straps feel very strong. You shouldn't really have to worry about the kid getting his hands under the strap. But again, I always have his feet towards the bottom end, but I know some people might, depending on how they're doing it, they might have it in different areas. But yeah, no, like I said, it's been an amazing product. I'll throw an Amazon link in the bottom so you guys can go and take a look at it. Definitely very awesome product. Very, very awesome product. Now, the Kobu camera. Now, you saw us do an unboxing and kind of an initial setup, but we never actually made it back to actually talk about the camera. Now, this has actually been a pretty big lifesaver for us. I mean, obviously, we haven't had any issues where our son almost died or anything like that, but it's been one of those things that we can literally have him in the crib or even downstairs in the living room, and we can actually aim the camera right at him and just kind of go and do our own thing. So we can actually check on him, make sure he's still asleep, or if he's moving around, we can kind of watch him move around and talk to him. It's actually been a really remarkable camera overall. And as you see here on the website, you can kind of see the first thing that they actually show you is covered face detection. Now, for us, we haven't really had to worry about that too much, just because the particular mattress we purchased allows you to kind of breathe through the mattress. But it is one of those things that you kind of like, yeah, you might not have bought an expensive mattress, or your mattress that you purchased might not allow, isn't really breathable. So I can see if your child's between, you know, newborn and 3 or 4 months, smothering, if they, you know, as they're starting to roll over and they're freaking out and they don't know what to do, smothering could be a big issue. And it's one of those things that, you know, I would definitely recommend most parents to actually pick up a camera just so they can actually see their child. And like I said, with the detection, being able to detect if their face is covered, same thing with like a blanket. If the blanket goes over the face, boom, it actually will tell you. And so far, our kid's pretty good about being able to kick it off and all that fun stuff. But obviously, when it starts to happen, he freaks out and he's kicking and screaming, and he'll get it off by the time we get in there. But you could tell he freaks out. He's still a baby. So definitely a cool camera. It does have night mode. It has a danger zone detection, so it can, pretty much protect your kid all the way up to 5 years old. My thing is a 1080p camera, in today's standards might still be relevant in the future. So say you want to actually keep an eye on the house, 10 years from now even. It actually might still work for that. But like I said, 0 to 5 year olds, definitely trying to keep them out of like a kitchen or stairwell or stuff like that. You can actually sit there and set up zones, and it is actually very instantaneous how it shows up. Now the night view is actually very remarkable. As you're looking at these two images here, the Kobu AI is actually this sharp as you're looking at it. The other monitors, obviously, they're kind of showing that's, it's kind of fuzzy and doesn't look as sharp. I am actually very impressed on what Kobu has done with their camera. You don't see any of the red lights that, other cameras you would see for night lights and all that fun stuff. As well as the it does have a kind of like a night light that's on top, so it kind of illuminates up high, so it's not totally dark in the room. Very, 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 very cool device. I can't tell people, how nice it is to be able to, have answers for like the doctors. Oh, is your child sleeping enough? Okay, well, actually, I could pull up a report, and I'll be like showing him a report on my phone, and be like, so he sleeps about right now in the crib. He's sleeping about, we'll say, 8 to 9 hours at night. He'll probably wake up here and here and here. Obviously, he's feeding, and then we put him right back into the crib, and he is good to go. I guess that's very remarkable. A lot of doctors I saw, they're like, oh, I didn't know that there was app that actually did that. And for me, some of the cool things that it actually does, that I don't know if they actually talk about on there. Actually, no, they do here. It's actually automatic photo capture. So as your child's doing fun things or smiling or doing, just doing random or wacky things that are cute, it'll actually take those pictures, and you'll actually be able to have them on your phone. And that is actually really cool as well. And most people don't realize, how many moments you could miss while they're in the crib that they just do something that you just n wouldn't have seen. But it is actually really, really, really cool. And I do love the design. As they say here, a unique design. It's kind of in the shape of a bird, so it doesn't look too out of place. It doesn't look too technology related. It looks like it would be something that would fit in a child's room. That was actually something that was very, very, very cool. And I'd say probably the last thing on it really is the temperature and humidity. Since we don't have central AC in the house, the rooms upstairs do tend to get a little hotter. So right now we're able to actually stay downstairs until, we'll say, like 9 or 10 at night, before we move our child upstairs. Whereas we're letting the rooms cool, I can actually go on the app, look at the temperature and the humidity, and go, okay, now it's at 81 degrees now, so we can take him up there, and it's actually cool enough for him to actually be in there. When it's like 87, 88, and there you go up there, and it's just like, oh man, it is hot up here, and it's 9 o'clock at night, at night. So we can actually leave him downstairs a little longer and do other things while we're waiting. So like I said, there's a lot of little things that this camera does that, I can't really, I can't really say I saw this many features in a camera, any other camera. So, all right. So I hope you guys like my 5 picks for useful items for the first 3 months of your child's life. And like I said, it's not just for the child, but more aimed at the adults and helping them save time and different things like that. Like I said, those are my top 5 items. Obviously, like I said, there could be strollers and beds and all that fun stuff, but these are just like items that I feel are actually affordable, time savers, or helps you stay organized, very easy to go, easy to grab items. So it's like I said, that's a big thing for me. But like I said, if you guys actually have a different five that you think would be actually better, definitely post them in the comments below. Like I said, I am a first timer father, and that's kind of, you know, for me, I don't know everything, but like I said, so far in my 3 months, these have been big, helpful items. And like I said, it's just one of those things that I might not know of something that might be totally different, might be better, or there might be something that you don't like about any of the products. And if there's like a little risk, definitely put them in the comments and I can do another video talking about that as well. Just because obviously safety is big for me, and I definitely want to, how can I say this? I definitely want to, you know, be putting out proper information, just because this is a baby channel, or not baby channel, but this is a baby segment. And, I do want to, you know, give you guys the best. But anyway, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, lower right hand corner for you guys. Don't forget to also hit that like button below. It definitely helps us out. And like I said, if you want to comment, add anything in there, or say, hey, there's 10 items that I would recommend, or another 5 items, definitely put them in the comments. Let me know. Definitely will be something that I do look at. And we'll get back to you as well if there's a question. It usually takes us about an hour or two, but we'll usually get back to you right away. But again, don't forget, we're here every Wednesday for Baby Edition. So just definitely watch. And we do a lot of other things on our channel as well. Definitely check out our Monday and Friday video uploads, as well as we live stream video games on the weekends and a few days during the week as well. Anyway, YouTube, thank you for watching. We will be back. And yeah, anyway, see you later. Have fun. And don't forget, Instagram and Facebook are down below as well. Check us out there too. Laters. Woo!